next half hour on GDGC, the best spots to check out in Green Country this weekend. We're counting them down in the bucket list. And the best way to keep your family safe. How getting to know your pharmacist can help. Plus tips for parents trying to juggle school and kids. That's all coming up this half hour. Now, earlier in the show, we talked about a JCPenney ad that has people raising their eyebrows. Here it is. Take a look at it. Some people think that teapot looks like Hitler. Lindsay says it looks like a butler. Well, you guys commented via Twitter and Facebook, and here's what you had to say. Randy Painter says the purpose of an ad is to get you to remember what is being sold. I'd say it worked, and a lot of people are duped. Have a good day. Winky. Todd Crane says, come on, really, people? It's just a teapot. If people are that concerned about it, they need to get a life. There are much more important things to worry about in this world. Thank you, Todd. There's still time to chime in. Go to facebook.com/greatdaygreencountry, or you can also tweet us at GDGCTulsa. Now, everybody wants amazing abs and a strong core, but nobody likes crunches. I don't. Clint Howard, exercise and physiologist and founder of Tulsa Fitness Systems, here to tell us about the anti-crunch six-pack solution. I love it because I can't stand doing crunches for two reasons. My neck hurts when I do crunches, and I'm already laying down, so I may as well just continue laying down.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
No, one of my coaches used to tell me, if you're laying down, you're having a bad day. And you're working out. So, crunches, really, there's a lot of research now. Crunches, actually, when you do a crunch, your hip flexors are actually doing most of the work. Your abs are only working for about 30 degrees of that 90-degree flexion.
Interesting.
And so the abs aren't really even working very much. And obviously, you put a lot of strain. You said your neck and also your lower back. You're compressing your disc. And so, like, if I wanted to come up with a way to, like, hurt my back, a crunch is what I would actually try to do. Like, how can I hurt my back? Let's do crunches.
Okay, so let's not do crunches.
Exactly. And so they're really the core, the abs are trained to stabilize and actually lengthen and not crunch and shorten. So,
cool. So you've come up with this exercise.
We call it 3D training, triplanar. When we talk about the abs, there's the six-pack, the rectus abdominis, everybody kind of knows. There's a lot of other muscles that make up your abs. These side muscles called obliques, intercostals, transverse abdominis.
I can't see any of them.
So. We all have them. Now, that's nutrition's another topic to get them out. But really, you want to train the abs, the core, and all different planes of motion doing different exercises.
Okay, and Sheila's here. Hi, Sheila. Yeah, thanks for being here. Show me some exercises, what you're going
to
do.
First thing, we're going to a plank, okay? A plank is a basic exercise here. A lot of people know we're going down to the elbows. Mm-hmm. And this is a basic plank here. So the core is engaged, squeezed in tight. The glutes are working.
I wanted to ask you this because I did this the other day, and I start trembling. You know, because after a while, and I'm wondering, is this good for me?
Yeah, like she can modify this. So if you go to your knees, like a basic plank, someone should be able to hold for at least 30 seconds.
Okay.
So it's just, basic. From there, we can get more advanced as well. Now, Sheila's very strong. She's been doing this for a long time. She can lift a leg up. That's going to get more challenging. So she's got her core's working a little harder now. She's unstable. You can even go what we call a two-point plank. So now she's going to go here, really challenging. You see that core starting to shake a little, her glutes are turning. So that's a little more advanced, but you can start out basic on your knees
and
do a basic plank here. So,
Nicely done.
A lot of people know what a mountain climber is.
Yes.
So mountain climbers are a great exercise for the core, but also even here, we can take it up a notch and do some different variations. And so when we're down here, we can go what we call Spider-Man. So now she's going out to the side. This is starting to engage a little more through the obliques and also just again hitting a different plane of motion. And we can also do one more variation here where she's going underneath and across. So we're starting to rotate. So it's really just
And I notice she's staying real flat back.
Is that important? This is perfect. Flat back, so your body wants to go down, obviously, and sag.
Right.
So you're keeping the hips up square, flat back. You don't want to hike your rear, and those cores are just locked in like someone's going to punch you in the stomach. They're locked in solid.
Those two exercises work in so many different muscles.
Oh, yeah, a lot of different variations. And one other thing, too, we do a lot of stuff with resistance tubing.
Right.
Now you can stand up and really start to work different rotational patterns here. So first thing here, she's going to do what we call anti-rotation. So she's just walking out, her arms are extended, and just walk. So her body is trying to come back in. So the core is locked in to prevent you from rotating. So we call it anti-rotation. So your abs are just getting fired up.
That's interesting. You're working your abs without, like,
without even moving. Yeah, they're just stabilized.
It's a core. That's awesome.
Yeah, and then we got two more quick ones here.
Okay.
She's going overhead. This is called an overhead frontal reach. So it's a different plane of motion. We call it the frontal plane. And so now we're starting to fire up the obliques here and still working the core, just a different plane of motion.
That's a good one. And then one more.
And then last one is a rotation. So now working the rotational transverse. Now really starting to fire up as we rotate. Again, just blasting the core at another angle.
That's okay, awesome. And you haven't hurt your lower back. You haven't hurt your neck. You haven't done this
exactly
thing.
Everything's safe. The abs are engaged. And we're hitting them from several different angles.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Thank you,
Sheila. Good work.
Yeah.
You can find out more about this workout and about Tulsa Fitness System by visiting our website. It's greatdaygreencountry.com.